Let's see how the OutSystems platform validates inputs submitted by the end user. We will start with mandatory fields and data type validation, and we will do this here in the product detail page. The first thing that I want to show you is that in our form, actually in the button that we have in our form, we have a property which is called validation. The platform supports validation of the user inputs in the browser, also known as client-side validation, and in the server, also known as server-side validation. So here the values, we have server, meaning that this is validation of the inputs server-side. We also have client and server, meaning that we have client-side validation and server-side validation. And finally, you can also set the button validation property to none, meaning that no validations will be performed by the OutSystems platform. Now, what happens here, and let's first leave this as server-side validations. What happens here is that in our inputs, as you've seen in the previous lessons, we've been setting the mandatory property according to the definition of our entity. So here, the name and the price are both mandatory attributes. This means that on this form, the name and the price will need to be filled in. When the form is submitted, the mandatory attributes are validated to see if the end user has filled in the data on these inputs. This is mandatory field validation. The platform also checks data type validation, meaning that the information that the user types in each one of these inputs needs to match the data type of that attribute. So for instance here, this is the price input. It's bound to the price attribute of the entity, and the price attribute of the entity is a currency. So if the user types in here something which is not a currency, we will have also an error for that. Now, how do we trigger these automatic validations? We need to set here this parameter validation. This means that the platform will validate all these mandatory attributes and data type in the server, and in the screen action of this save button, in this action here, you must check if the information that we have in the form is valid or not. And we will do this here by adding a piece of logic with an if to validate if our form is valid or not. And the condition here for this is we're going to use the product form, which is the form we have on the page. Besides the record property we've been using, we still have here another property, which is the valid property. And this means that, let me just select here, this means that if any of the inputs we have in the form is not valid, then this property will have a false value because this is of Boolean data type. So this means that this is false. And if this is false, in that case, let me just add here an end note. We don't want to continue to send the information into the database. So I need here to swap these connectors. Use here this option. So if the form is not valid, I will not continue to send the data to the database. This means that the save action will end, the preparation will be executed, and the form will be rendered again with the indication that the inputs are not valid. So let's see this in action in our application. Okay, so let's go here into the products and let's create a new product. And before we continue, let me just go back here to the development environment and set a breakpoint here in the save action and launch the debugger here. Okay, so let's go back to our application and let's try to save this new product without giving it a name. Remember that a name is a mandatory attribute, so when we save, We're stopped in the breakpoint. When we save, let me step over. The valid property of the form is false. And it's false because the input for the name is not valid because I haven't filled in the name. So let's continue and see what happens in our application. And there you have it. You have the indication that the name is a required field. So we need to fill in here USB camera, for instance. And you see that, for instance, the price is a mandatory attribute we filled in with zero. If we remove this value and we try to save it again we will have this property as not valid. Let me just here remove the breakpoint so that we can continue testing. Let's go back to our application. So this is a required field, and if I type here something which is not the currency, for instance some text, and I try to save, this will tell me that this is a currency and the value that I entered here is not a currency. And if I type in something like this and I save, then here I have my new product and the validations are working. That's it.